This tutorial is going to show you how to make a diagonal line in Illustrator. So if you live in Morgantown, you probably had to work with WVU before, and they have this great element that you can add to your designs for visual interest, and that is this diagonal line that is a nod to the flying WV, so it has the same sort of angle. And it has some strict rules, so you can only use navy, blue, white, and gold, and it has to be at this 33.75 degree angle. So over here, I have some rectangles already made. If you don't know how to make a rectangle, you go to your rectangle tool and click and drag and you'll have your rectangle. So with it selected, you're going to go up to Object, Transform, Shear. And this angle is where you're going to put in your 33.75. I have preview clicked so you can see what it would look like. And what's unique about this is you have the straight line at the top and the bottom, and the diagonal is on the side, it's on each side. Horizontal is clicked for axis, you say okay, and it makes the correct diagonal. So what is wrong is if you go Object, Transform, Rotate, you still have this angle, 33.75, but you see it's actually just rotating it like a hand on a clock rather than shearing it, giving it the form of the flying WV. All right, so I'm gonna select all of these and say Object Transform again, which is going to shear them. Actually, I'm gonna undo, not select the one I've already done. Object Transform Shear, 33.75, okay. Duplicate, I'm holding down Option on my Mac. So the guideline's going to say that these can be used as elements on top of photographs. A lot of times they're used to lead your eye to something you want to look at. You can use different scale, so they can be larger or smaller. They're allowed to overlap each other. Object Arrange, bring to front. You're also allowed to have transparency or opacity. So you might do that with your transparency over here. You can bring down. The opacity to add some visual interest. Over here, you'll see three examples of ads where they're using these diagonals to help frame and point to the text. And this one has an example of scale and also opacity.